Hello everyone and welcome back to your English class with Ivy ma'am. Today we are going to revise our topic nouns. So nouns for class 1. Okay, now children, just look around you. What all can you see? Mobile, yes. The first thing you said is mobile, yes. Very good. What else? Come on, tell me. Fan, okay. Clock, wonderful. Bed, chair, table, mug, cup. Mother, oh, your mother is also there. Wow, very good. Okay, your sister, your brother. What else? Papa, okay, your father. What else? Come on. See what all you can see. Your slippers, your shoes, your uniform, your dress, your books, your pencil, your pencil box, and so on. So children, did you notice that whatever you saw had a name? So children, everything around us has a name. Even we have a name, na? What's my name? Ivy ma'am. What's your name? Vava. So, everyone has a name. Everything has a name. So, everything around us has a name. That means that names are nouns, because you had already learned that names are nouns. So, now everything has a name and names are nouns. Okay, children. Now remember one thing, all naming words are known as nouns. Okay, what are nouns? If anybody will ask you what are nouns, what will you say? All naming words are called as nouns. All naming words are known as nouns. Okay, anybody tells you next time, come on, give me the definition or tell me what is nouns. So then you can say, all naming words are known as nouns. Very good. So now children, another definition to nouns. Name of a person, place, animal or thing is known as a noun. Is known as a noun. Name of a person, place, animal or thing. Person, place, animal or thing is known as a noun. Is known as a noun. So remember that naming words are nouns, and name of person, place, animal or thing is known as a noun. Okay, let's see names of person now. Come on, give me names of person. Boy, girl, Raju, Pinky, mother, father, sister, child, baby, brother, and so on. Wonderful. Now names of place. Can you see this house? You live in a house, na? House is also a place. Okay. So let's see some places now. Sevagram, Bhuj, Rajasthan, Nagpur, park, garden, school, library, shop, complex, mall, Delhi, city, and so on. Now it's time to see some animals. Oh, I can see a squirrel on the screen. You know, squirrel is my favorite animal. I love squirrels. Do you love squirrels? Okay. Now children, under this category, the animals, all the insects and the birds also are included. Okay. So these are all the creatures that come under one category, animals. Okay. So you can name all the animals along with the birds and insects and so on. Come on, name. Cat, dog, if your dog has a name, Bruno, then yes, Bruno. Lion, elephant, tiger, peacock, butterfly, ant, and so on. Now, Let's discuss things. There are so many things you saw just now in your room around you, na? Can you see the crayon on the screen? Oh, you love to color with the crayon, na? That's also a name. So, noun. So, let us discuss names of some things. Pencil, eraser, mobile, table, chair, bed, bicycle, toys, books, and so on. So now we have discussed that. What all we have discussed? Come on, you tell me first. Yes. All naming words are known as nouns. We have also discussed that names of person, place, animal, and thing are known as nouns. Okay, and we saw the examples also, na? Examples also we saw of person, place, animal, and thing. Now, children, what you are supposed to do is, please take out your classwork notebook, the grammar notebook, okay? Now, in the grammar notebook, take a fresh page. First thing you will do is put the date, okay? Put today's date. Very good. After that, you put classwork above the margin. Don't put it below the margin. Right at the center, the middle, you will put it above the margin. CW, classwork. Then in the first line below the margin, you will write the heading nouns. Now, N should be capital. Capital N-O-U-N-S. Nouns. Very good. Now, you will leave one line and you will write, start with capital N. Okay, start with capital N, N-A-M-E, name of, O-F of, a, we will not say a, it is a, name of a, then you will write person, P-E-R, per, S-O-N-S-O-N, person. Now children, please leave 2 finger space after every word. Okay, so that it looks neat and tidy, right, in beautiful handwriting. Leave 2 finger space after every word. Okay, now you have written the word person, then put a comma. Then you write P-L-A-C-E, place. Place, place. P-L-A-C-E-S, place. Now put a comma. Then you write animal, A-N-I, Annie, M-A-L, M-A-L, animal. Have you written that? Then you write O-R-R. Then you write T-H-I-N-G, T-H, T-H-I-N-G, ing, thing. I-S is K-N-O. W-N, known. A-S as a N-O-U-N, noun. Put a full stop. Then you leave a line and you will write, start with capital letter A-L-L-All. Don't forget to leave 2 finger space. Naming, N-A-M I-N-G, naming, W-O-R-D-S, words, A-R-E-R, C-A-L-L-E-D, called, N-O-U-N-S, nouns, full stop, leave one line, and then you will write, EX. EX is the short form of example. Now you are giving the example of nouns. So you write E with capital, X small, EX, put a dash, and then you write the examples. G-I-R-L, girl, comma, M-O-T-H-E-R, father, comma, R-A-M, Ram, comma, B-H-U-J, Bhuj, comma, P-A-R-K, Park, comma, C-I-T-Y, City, comma, S-C-H-O-O-L, School, comma, P-E-N, Pen, comma, B-O-O-K, Book, comma, C-A-R, Car. Now you will write, there are many more, no? So you cannot write all the words, right? All the names you cannot write, it is very difficult. So now you write, ETC, dot, full stop. Okay, ETC, full stop. ETC means, etc. and so on, and so on, and so on. Okay, wonderful. Now children, Ivy ma'am has made a worksheet for you. Now you see this worksheet carefully. Now this is your practice worksheet 1. Now this also you have to do it in your classwork notebook. Okay, this is your practice worksheet 1. This you have to do it in your English classwork notebook. So there you will write the date, you will write the classwork, and then you will write, underline the nouns in the given sentences. Children, what you have to do is, you have to find the names in the sentences, because all names are nouns. So you have to underline these nouns. Okay. So the first sentence, Ram is playing in the garden. Ram is playing in the garden. What are the names? There are two names in this. Think what it is. Thought? Okay, keep it in your mind. Keep it in your mind now. Now the second sentence is, Seema is going to Nalia. Seema is going to Nalia. Now again, think. There are two nouns in this also. Now think, what are those two nouns? Keep it in mind. Okay, keep it in your mind. Now let's see the third sentence. My father works in the office. Where my father works? In the office. My father works in the office. Here also, children, there are two nouns. Now think, what are those two nouns? Thought? Keep it in your mind. Fourth sentence. I like to play with toys. I like to play with toys. Oh, here there's only one name. Only one noun. Think what it is. Thought? Now keep it in your mind. Okay, now next sentence. The glass is on the table. The glass is on the table. Again there are two nouns. Think what it is. Thought? Kept it in your mind. No shouting, no shouting. Keep it in your mind. Okay, wonderful. Now, let's see the answers. Okay, so in the first sentence, the answers are Ram and garden. Did you get it right? Wonderful, thumbs up. Second sentence, Seema is going to Nalia. There are two nouns, Seema and Nalia. Did you get it right? Thumbs up. Okay, my father works in the office. What is the answer? Father, office. So you will underline father and office. Did you get it right? Wonderful. Fourth sentence, I like to play with toys. What is the answer? Toys, because there was only one noun. So the noun is toys. I know you got it right. Thumbs up. Now fifth sentence, the glass is on the table. There are two nouns, glass and table. Did you underline that? And did you get it right? Thumbs up. Amazing. Okay, children, now Ivy ma'am said, I have made one worksheet for you. But Ivy ma'am has made actually two worksheets for you. So let's see the second worksheet also now. What does this worksheet say? Now you have to do this also in your classwork notebook. Now this is practice worksheet 2. Now children, in this also you have to write the classwork, okay? CW along with today's date. Date is very important. Classwork is very important above the margin, alright? Then on the first line you will write, the given nouns in the right column. There are so many nouns, can you see? In this table over here, you have to pick these nouns and put it in the correct column. Okay, so how many nouns are there? Let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, I have put 9 nouns, 9 names. You have to put it according to the category, person, place, thing. Ma'am has not put animals here. No problem. Okay, we only have to categorize here person, place, thing. Okay, let's see now. The first word is doctor. The second word is fan. The third word is budge. The fourth word is school. The fifth word is mother. The sixth word is cap. The seventh word is Riya. The eighth word is garden. The ninth word is spoon. Okay, now keep thinking. Come on, think which word will go in which column. Think, I'm giving you a little bit of time. Come on, you are very fast and you're very smart. I know you can do it fast. You must be shouting now and saying, ma'am, this word will go here and this word will go there and this noun will go here. You know, I know you all are very smart. Yes. Okay. Now, shall we see the answers? Shall we see whether you have guessed it right or not? Chalo, let's see then. Here we have the answers. Okay. Now, the first word, doctor. Doctor is a person. So, we will put doctor in which column? Person. The second word, fan. Fan. Now, fan is a thing. So, we will put fan in thing. Next is budge. B-H-U-J. Budge. Now, budge is a place. Come on, fast. Put the budge in place. Now, you've put it in the correct column. Now, next fourth word is school. Now, school is a place. So, again, you're going to put school in place. Now, next is mother. Oh, I love my mother. You also love your mother, na? Yes. So, mother will go in which column? Person. Yes. Next is cap. Cap. Cap is a thing. So, cap comes under thing. Very good. Next is Riya. And Riya is a person. So we will put Riya in person. Now next, garden. Garden is a place. So we will put garden in place. Very good. You're going really wonderful. Last word is spoon. Do you use the spoon to eat? Or you use your hands? You should use a spoon, you know. Because your hands remain dirty sometimes. You don't even wash sometimes. So if you're using a spoon, that way it is better. Okay. So now, spoon is a thing. So spoon will go in thing. Wonderful, children. You have done it great. Really, you have done a wonderful job. So children, we have revised our topic nouns. Now keep practicing more and more to become perfect with the concept. If children, parents and teachers, if you have liked our video, don't forget to like, share, subscribe and press the bell icon. Keep waiting for the next video. Till then, tata bye.